Hey, Justin, what did you think of Drew's throw on that fake punt?
I've never seen that. I've never seen that play in practice, but I was just on the bench, saw that, and I was just amazed like that. That was crazy.
What did you say about your coach, your head coach, to call that at that time of that position?
He's got balls. He definitely has faith in our team, so that shows me how much trust he has in the players. I knew that I didn't perform. I think I played pretty average this game, really below average, if I had to grade myself. But I think it was a total team effort win, and I'm
glad we got it. Was there a moment in the third quarter when you felt things flip, when you kind of felt like, all right, this is our game now?
I think at the end of the second quarter was when we all knew it was our game, when we scored and stopped them on defense and going into the half, knowing we got the ball back in the third quarter. I think that's when the whole team knew that we were going to win the game.
You converted some third and longs. You hit Olave on that scramble for like 50 yards, and then Ben Victor broke the tackles like 27 yards. Just how important, I mean, those are two plays right there that really swung this game.
Well, third downs are a big part in a football game, and if you convert, you definitely have a better chance in winning that. So I think we did a good job on third down today, and I think that's kind of one of our best things as a team is just third down defense and third down offense. So I think we managed that well today.
How would you critique Drew Chrisman's throw on the fake punt?
You said what?
How would you critique Drew Chrisman's throw on the fake punt?
I didn't see it. I didn't see it because I did not see it coming. I just saw the first down, but it was crazy just seeing that, and just coach just seeing the face he had in him.
Justin, I heard there's heart and adjustments is the thing I kept hearing in here. And coach, I just heard him say something about there's some guys barking at each other. What do you think turned it?
Well, what turned it for the offense is we knew that we weren't playing up to our potential in the first half. So just going out there in the second half and playing our game, I think that's what helped us.
How good does this feel?
I mean, it feels great. And just knowing that we haven't even touched our potential and reach and limit gives us more hope and more confidence for the future.
How about that three-game grind? That's a hell of a run right there.
Yeah, it was. I mean, Coach Day prepared us for that grind and told us it was going to be hard, but I think the team and the coaches handled it well, and we got through it.
What percentage did you play at today?
I think I was around probably 85, 90.
Close.
Try to get in the training room.
So in 3 weeks, you'll be
three
good
weeks,
as new.
3 weeks, I should be good. Yeah.
How excited are you to just rest and take some time off?
I'm definitely excited for the break, you know. Just got to be in the training room, trying to get my knee right, and just trying to watch film on whoever we play next.
Are you still number one? Are you still number one?
Are we still number one?
Yeah, if you had the call.
I think so, yes, sir.
I'm sorry if these guys asked me that. Just how much did it hurt tonight? How much did it hinder you and all that knee?
My knee wasn't too bad tonight. I think the brace kept it pretty stable, so just having the brace helped my knee out a lot.
It kind of looked like during warm-ups you may have stayed out there longer than normal just to get a feel for it.
Yeah, because really today was my first time kind of planning on it 100%, so I was just trying to get a feel for the knee brace and just test it out a little bit.
Did you have more of that as the game went on? Because I think in the second half you looked a lot more comfortable to me.
Yeah, I mean, I've never played in a knee brace like that before, so it really just takes time to get used to.
Hey, Justin, when you came into this season, you and Ryan Day were first-year guys and a lot more about movement. As you stand here right now, are you surprised at where you guys got in your first year and reflect on what this journey has been like, just working with Ryan?
Well, me personally, I definitely didn't know it was going to be like this, but just as I kind of, I guess, spent more and more time with the coaches and the players, I got more confident in this team and just this brotherhood and what we actually could accomplish.
You've played for a lot of different coaches in your life, some at this level and some at high school. How would you characterize the job that Ryan Day has done this year with this team? And were you ever surprised at just how successful he could be after just 1 year?
Yeah, I mean, he's definitely a great coach, a great person too. And I think the team not only plays for his coaching, but I think we have a personal relationship with him. So just having that love for coaches, I think that makes us all play harder.
What about you, though, coming in at the same time? I mean, a lot of people thought new coach, new quarterback, this team's going to lose 3 games. To come in and have a personal connection in terms of timing. See what I'm saying?
Definitely do. Just coming in at the same time with Coach Day, but that just shows you how much work we have put in, and just shows you how bright the future will be.
Thanks, Justin.
Justin, what has this journey from Georgia to Ohio State? How has that molded you as a person?
I think it's made me a stronger person. You know, definitely made my faith stronger, because I would never. I really just never see myself in this place right now. So just being here right now is just I'm just really speechless, because I really just never thought I'd be here.
And you're all about your family, we know that, but have you gotten a really good sense of family here at the Buckeyes too?
I mean, of course. I mean, all these guys, we're all brothers, so just winning this and just having this special moment with them just makes it all better.
Justin, why are you and how are you able to be so chill on the sideline when you guys are down?
Yeah. I can't really put my finger on it, but it's just like, I think it just has something to do with my faith. I mean, I was just asking God for guidance and just in the game, so really, it's up to him.
Were you ever panicking internally?
Not really. I feel like in high school, that's kind of happened to me before, so just looking back on that situation, just staying calm and just trying to get back to my game, I think that helped me out a lot.
And how did your knee hurt during the game at all?
No, not really. I mean, there was probably a few cuts where it hurt a little bit, but other than that, for the most part, it was good.
What about that first sack you took? It looked like you landed right on your knee.
Nah. Surprisingly, that didn't hurt. So nice. Good, yeah.
Did you feel like the knee affected any of your throws, or you feel like it was all right there?
I feel like it did, but I'm not making excuses for the for the missed throws, of course, but I definitely feel like it did, so hopefully next game, I won't have to wait on you guys.
Yeah, great.
Justin, what was KJ doing so well to get open in the second half?
I mean, that's how he is. He's a great player, a great receiver. He's smart and athletic, and he has great hands. So KJ was being himself.
What did you think when Jeremy caught that?
I was surprised, because literally in practice, when we go drills, he just practices one hand. I swear, like, he catches them like crazy. So just seeing that happen in the game, that's just amazing to see.